What's up, y'alls? Today I'm working on the shield animation. Already there's a shield animation, right? But when you get hit, there's like a little like purple wave type thing that goes. But what I want to do now is something where you know when it's up, because what you have to do is sit still for it to be active, which isn't very clear as a player. You don't really know whether it's up or it's not. So what I'm going to do is add a little purple outline, like a glowing shield type thing whenever the player is still. So if you start moving, it'll go away. If you sit there, it'll be there. So I've already started something where it can mirror the sprite, but I'm just waiting for it. Now I gotta refine that. So basically I gotta work on the shader. I need a special shader for it. It's kind of broken, it's not working yet. And then I need to align it. Couple of things. So let's start with the color. I'm thinking, I don't know why the color. Why is this color so dark? Let's just do something really easy here. Just multiply that by 2. What's up, Rocket? How you doing, man? What's up? Yeah, Wizzy Boy right here. B-boying up your favorite B-boy moves. That's a little brighter, but still, it's not. I think I might have to do the frag color. What's with that? What? You're in Portland? Really? Wow, man. 1.5 feet? That's so much snow for Oregon? For Portland? Wow. That's crazy, man. So let's do only one of those. What's up, Eves? What's up, Exotic Burns? Hello, guys. So I'm thinking this should probably be a frag shader. Little hangout for bed, right on. Unless I just multiply it by a lot, like what if I just. Now he's white. Definitely not that much. So if you just joined the stream, what I'm working on right now is a shield up animation. So the way the shield works is you sit there, you sit still for a minute, and then the shield comes up. So I want an animation that kind of shows that. So I want to do an outline type thing. Okay, so next thing I wanted to do is fade in. Ooh, I think I already did an anim function for that. Whoa, Rocket, that's so much snow. Dude, it's crazy. So, Rocket, how are you liking Portland so far? I mean, you've only been there for a minute. Have you even been to school yet there? Exotic Burns, yes, this is C++. Okay, let's see if that looks good with it animating in. Really got to make it more the right color though. So I got to use a sh I got to program a fragment shader, I think. Why didn't the vert shader. Guess the vert shader for the other one just never worked. Why didn't that animation work? Still not working. This anim function. What's up with this? Not yet. School's out? Yeah. Wow, Rocket. That's crazy. You might not have to go to school for a while. In Oregon, it doesn't snow that much like that. Not in the cities. So they're probably like, school's canceled. Oh, this might actually be this shader. That's might be the problem. What languages do I know besides C++? Lots of them. Lots of them, my friend. C, PHP. God, the list goes on, man. Let's go from 2 to 255. I think the problem is the shader. Whoa, what was that? Yeah, I know, Rocket. I spent like a good 15 minutes working on that. There's some crazy ass bugs with this shit right now. Game show just released a new version or whatever. And I can't edit anything. And I think my is the screen black for you guys when I do this? When I go to this one thing to try and edit the scene or whatever and change the chat box, it turns black. I can't see anything. So if I try and move stuff or change things around, it's like stab it in the dark. I move it and then switch back to this view and be like, ah, did it work? Anxiety burns. No, I do not know Java. I know the basics of Java, but that's it. Okay, so it's not that. Okay, with that means that We need to use the fragment colors alpha. Actually, this is all zero, and this is the fragment colors alpha. Oh, that's totally going to change the way this whole thing works. Let's change this bit. Wait, nah, that's going to mess up. Damn, we're going to have to change this to just 1.0. What the hell? Okay, the first thing to try is turning off the shader. Yes, I'm so glad, Rocket. I'm so glad. Java's slow and not very portable compared to C++. Not as portable. It's still pretty portable. Wait, now it's gone? What the hell? What happened? Okay, well, start. Oh, I didn't fade it in at all. Eves is like, yeah. Oh, there it goes. Okay, it's fading in. It's a good start. Yes, you're a bad person. You're such a bad person. Switching from C++ to C#. Jeez. There's like a level of hell for people like you. It's like the fifth level of the ring of hell. Dante wrote about it in his Inferno. It's classic. Yep. He wrote, "Those that switch from C++ to C# will forever burn in the fifth level of hell." I promise he totally wrote that. Oh yeah, Minecraft mods, nice. Wait, did it work? Did it fade in? It like faded in the opposite, didn't it? It's like it's white, then it goes to the color. What's up with that? Oh yeah, you're always paranoid. So what made you switch? And just for the record, if anybody's not catching the joke, I don't think C# is a bad language. I think all languages are great. They all have their purpose. They all have, you know, certain strengths and weaknesses. And C++ has got a lot of strengths. C#. And Java too. Java's got a lot of great strengths. Yeah, this effect might be neat. I just want to try looking at it this time with the sprite at the right position. Oh, it's going to need to be added halfway. In the middle of the, its position p.x plus equals e.render.sprite dot get content size dot width times a half. Even Lua? Yes, even Lua. Lua has its strengths. They all look the same to you? Well, when you're just starting out, they probably do look the same, but trust me, they are all different. Okay, this is looking weird. But let's do all three sprites now. Gotta get it to be the right color. So yeah, what I'm trying to get this to look like, let me show you the mock-up I did. This is kind of what it'll look like, but this is in Photoshop. In Photoshop, everything looks different than in the game because the game has all the lighting applied and stuff. So this purple color here will actually be a brighter color of purple, and his skin won't be as orange either. It'll also be a lot brighter. So this is kind of the concept, though, right, is that when you stand still, your shield becomes active, and you got this little glowing aura type thing. But why pick C++ over Java or something like C#? Yeah, Rocket Bunny has part of it there. It's not way faster, but it is faster than both Java and C#. And secondly, it's the most portable, it's one of the most portable popular languages out there. So there's so many compilers that have been written for C and C++ on so many different platforms and so many different chipsets that you can write your game with C++ and then easily port it to just about anything. And I'm talking Xbox, PlayStation, you know, Commodore 64, whatever you want to port your game to. C++ is going to be a way better starting point than Java or C#. Or a lot of, pretty much any, I can't think of a single language that's more portable than C. Oh, Eves, you used Cocoa Studio X before? Oh. Uh-huh. You tried different engines? Okay. All right. Cool, Eves. So, Eves, what kind of game do you want to make, man? Not Exotic Burns. You're missing the point of the portable part, though. Yeah, so yes, C++ is faster, but C++ is also more portable. So you can write your game in one code base and port it to more platforms than you could with Java or C#. I think I just explained that there. Let me know if you didn't understand that part about portable. Okay, where was I here? Oh, do we need to do a shader? The shader needs to look right. It's kind of cool, actually. But it's too bright. Okay, so the way the vertex shader works is it modifies the color of the vertices. So you're still actually getting the pixel fragment colors as they were through it. So yes, I need to actually do a fragment shader, not a vertex shader. So let's Control Z this, go to the shaders, and instead of shield.vert, we're going to have shield.frag. back in source game. This is gonna be null pointer, and then shield. Yeah, I did. I answered there. Yeah, about that. Yeah, I know. There's such a big delay with Twitch. Oh, sweet. Your new project's a month in. It's a game about a little shark in a zoo. Sweet, man. He's breaking out of his aquarium. Oh, that's cool, dude. Yeah, it's 2D pixel art. Oh, sweet, Eves. Oh, that's so awesome, man. Do you have like a working title or what? I know, doing pixel perfect is hard, but it's worth it, man. It's worth it. Don't give in. Don't take the easy road. Do the pixel perfect. It'll look so much better. Other artists will respect you so much more. No working title yet? All right, cool. Well, keep me posted, man. I want to hear about it. I want to play it. Yeah, Unity's floats. I hear you. It does. It makes it hard for pixel perfect. But I think there were some people here chatting in, like, it was a long time ago. It was like a year and a half ago, here chatting on the stream with me about getting Unity to be pixel perfect. And they had all these tricks and stuff like that that they did. So, gosh, I wish I could remember, like, what stream that was, because maybe you could reference that video. I know it's one of the videos. What video was that we were chatting about? I was kind of doing something else while they were... Wait, was it actually this... No, it was before I did the whole pixel perfect thing for Songbringer. Shit, I don't know what video that was, but it was one of them. Yeah, it's tricks. Yeah, yeah. You posted some stuff on Twitter? Let's take a look, man. Send me a link. I want to see. You can include... Yes, Rocket, you can include CPP files. Yep. I know, blow your mind. I just blew your mind, didn't I? This is how, Rocket, this is the basis of how you do Unity builds. A Unity build has nothing to do with Unity, the game engine. A Unity build simply means, like, you're in a compiler like C or C++ where you have header files. A Unity build basically makes it so you include a bunch of different CPP files into one compilation unit, so you don't have to reprocess all your header files. And it's a lot faster to compile C++ with a Unity build. But the problem is that your static variables and other local things that go into each CPP file get compiled all as one, so sometimes they can clobber each other and you get compiler errors. Who are these people? Yes, this is the shark guy. He looks so cool. That's so great. Awesome, Eves. Oh, I can't like it through this Twitch chat pop-up thing. Damn it. Here, I'll open it in my browser so I remember to check that out later. Nice job, Eves. That's so cool. Yeah, you're going to save it up for screenshot Saturday? Nice, nice, nice. Okay, so now we got to convert this shield vert. Shield.frag. Okay, so fragment shaders. Let me refresh my memory. Fragment shaders do these, and they take a varying vec. Ooh, let's take all that. This doesn't have any uniforms. Probably need both these. What's up, Panko? So I need to set the GL fragment color, I think. So, if you're just tuning into this stream, what I'm working on is a little shield up animation where you got this little aura when your shield is active, which means you're standing still. And I'm working on a shader to make that look cool. Oh, right. Sample the texture. That's right. Sample this. And then set the GL frag color, right? Okay. So we want to take the color, the GL frag color. Let's just do PEG4C equals texture 2D. We're sampling the texture with the VTEX cord. Is this already a VEC2? Why is it casting that? It's weird. Hope it gets a lucky in. Yeah, Rocket. Run away, it's shader code. So the only reason we're sampling that is for its alpha color. So we want to do the GL frag color. Equals a mix of 0 and this exact color. If the color we sampled's alpha value is greater than or equal to 1. So if we sample our texture, right, and we get a blank pixel, like one of these pixels out here, it won't do anything. And then if it does get a pixel, then it's going to make it just pink or purple, whatever this color is. Shaders are gross. What's up, Fluffy Biscuits? Shaders are hard, I'll tell you that. They're not easy to get right because how limited you kind of are when you're making them as far as debugging goes and stuff. Okay, well, is that going to work? Maybe this will. Yes, Exodium, I'm my own boss. And it's thanks to Kickstarter. So I did a Kickstarter in 2015 for Songbringer. And thanks to like 700 people who I will thank forever and ever and ever. I'm making this game. If it wasn't for them backing this project, I wouldn't be making this game. Maybe I would be making this game, but in my spare time, so it would take me like 10 years. Oh, there we go. Yes. It totally worked. Nice. It even looks cool. Yeah, it shows you your shield is up. Oh no, what happened? What happened? Oh, I think it needs its Z changed. Yeah, that looks good. Damn. That was pretty lucky just to get it right on the first try. Okay, but yeah, I think its Z needs to be updated whenever it's changed, actually. Sprite frame, no. Actually, it needs to be changed. I think it'll just work if I change it whenever the shield goes up, actually. That'll work. So we go set global Z order to that Z. Mm-hmm. Yes, he's got a little cardboard box. Zilton, what's up, man? Yeah, I know, the chat box. I tried to mess with it today and didn't really get very far. It's basically super buggy. Nice. So you stand still and boom, you got your shield. Nice. And if we don't have the shield, none of this should happen, and it shouldn't be any performing any worse or anything. Not much going on? Yeah, you should start working on a project, man. What you gonna work on? Okay, cool, that worked. You know the day I started? Yeah, you remember that? Right, when the Kickstarter hit its goal? Yeah, I did a drunk stream. I was drinking beer on the, or was it whiskey? I don't know. I don't know what I was drinking, but on the day the Kickstarter succeeded, I was drinking, man, it was great. I started coding and stuff, and I think I played Zelda. Okay, I think this works, man. This is sweet. Let's run around the overworld or something with it. Maybe it was beer and whiskey. Salad, what's up, man? I tried to fix the chat, but it didn't work. Oh, that looks different here on this. It kind of needs to be a different opacity. Jace, I don't need all these things up and buffer delete. Yes, yeah, stream Zelda. I should do that again, huh? You liking the shield? All right, cool. I'm thinking though it needs to be. I like how it starts out, but it's ends up a little bit too opaque. Like it'd be nice if it were transparent. Let's see what it looks like with the half the transparency. It gives you a DOS game vibe? Cool. Now it's all black. Whoops. That wasn't it. Oh, because I mixed in GV fragment colors alpha right here. Ow. Okay. That's right. Let's do just 0.5. Thanks, Eves. I appreciate that, man. It's been a lot of work converting all those art files. I haven't even finished, but it's so worth it. I mean, it looks a lot better. I agree. Oh, now he's not, now it doesn't do that cool flash at the beginning. Oh, maybe I'll clamp this. So wait. When the sprite is all super bright. Oh, the V fragment color dot A is the opacity. Oh, wait. So what if I just change this? Where it actually fades it in. There it is. Change this to half opacity. 2D DOS. You're getting a King's Quest vibe? Cool. It's a bad game. Tell me, yeah, Zilton, I want to hear. Tell me why you think King's Quest is a bad game. I definitely want to hear this. Oh, there we go. That totally works. So just leave the ending opacity a little bit. No idea why it's all bright at first, but it looks cool that way. It definitely gives you the feeling like, oh, he's protected or there's something going on where. Whoa, that was crazy. Was like stuck on a frame or something. There, it did it again. That's so cool. It's like an accident, but I like it. This is gonna be way better. As a player, you'll know when your shield's up. In fact, let's fight a really hard boss right now, because that will really help out playing somebody hard. Okay, to put it short, the odd gentleman took money from another game they weren't meant to be working on and shoveled it into King's Quest. Oh, well, but what is that, what about the game? Why do you not like the game though? I mean, what about the gameplay, the art, or whatever? Oh, you mean the new one? Oh, you're talking about the new King's Quest. Oh, I thought you were talking about the old King's Quest. Oh yeah, it kind of does look like the meditation. Six, five, ten. And that's zero. All right. Yeah, I didn't get it either. I wanted to. If they had made a new King's Quest with the old style artwork, all pixel art and stuff, I definitely would have played it. Yeah, 18 years ago for sure. Yeah, I've definitely heard of Thimbleweed Park. I backed that project on Kickstarter. was cool. I wanted to see the shield though when it got. This is chaos. Hit me. Hit me with that. That's so cool. You can definitely see like, okay, the shield's up. I know when the shield's up now. It's so helpful as a player. While I cheat. What's up, Ishni? What's up, man? How you doing? I thought about getting someone to make illustrations of Songbringer for the release. You mean, what do you mean? Like, concept art or something? Like paintings? Songbringer arcade machine? That'd be sweet. You're good? Oh, vector art? Oh, paint. You mean like vector art or like paintings? Like digital paintings? Like concept art? Let's get hit with this. I love it when the shield happens now. It's so cool. Getting pretty good at throwing bombs. It's gonna be like a speedrunner's best friend, throwing bombs and stuff. Wait, did I get the audio down? Sorry if this is. Oh, it's down. Okay. You really want to make an arcade machine now? Nice. Okay, that's awesome. I love this new shield animation. So cool. Yes, check it in. Check it in. Check it out, man. Check it in. Oh, that kind of art. Oh, yeah. Well, it's kind of a mix between concept and like and vector. Yeah, I do definitely need to do some kind of like really, really good marketing images. I'll be focusing on that towards the end of the project. All right, let's check this in. Have any OS with OS programming? OS making. Okay, I like this, but I want to make that clear. This is. Yeah, let's clean up this code a little bit, actually. Starting with this bit, this should be an Anim. So we'll start with the nims.age. And we'll call it enable shield and give it an id. That's really it. And a bool, whether it's enabled. You can't wait that long. All right, so this bit, these 10 lines of code, we yank those. So this is a function called enable shield. Hey, see you, Eves, later, man. Have a good night. Wait, which bull have you enabled? The one that's gonna take the whole world down. What the shit? Did you guys see that? What was that? Yeah, we're talking about Dex. The lead developer. Oh no, what? Oh man. Oh, that was last year or 2 years ago. Wow. Oh man. That sucks. Lose a creative soul like that. Especially so young. So young. So if this is an empty component, I'm just going to return. Or if it doesn't have any mirrored sprites. Then if we don't. Susie, how do I turn it on? How long have I been programming? 22 years? 20... No, I was 14, and now I'm 37. So, 23 years. Pie's no good unless you bake it. I used to call the Raspberry Pi the Raspberry Pi. Don't ask me why. It's one of those embarrassing things I don't want to admit about myself. But I just did. You're welcome. Okay, cool. We got this little nice, neat function called Anim's Enable Shield where we don't have to bury this animation code inside the input system or whatever that was. Where the hell was that? Oh, the attack system. You got syntax completion working? Yes, dude! What? That's crazy cool, dude. Yeah, I'm glad you finally got that going with the completion. That's so important. Does it work really good? Is it like as good as Xcode? Is it better than Xcode? Yeah, Rocket, you did. Rocket, you totally corrected me on that. You're like, wait. Raspberry Pi. Okay, so now we can call Anim's Enable Shield e.id true. Delete 12 lines. Here we can just paste in same thing. But false. Good. And then this bit too needs to be a little better. As good as Xcode. Wow. And it's faster. Yeah, I know. Xcode is so slow once you get it working in like Vim or Emacs. Oh, fuzzy auto completion. That would be so cool. So sweet, Salad. That would be so awesome. Fuzzy auto completion. If you get that working, tell me how you do it, man. I want to know. Inquiring minds want to know. All right, we're good. Let's see if this still works. Something when you use the blink, it actually doesn't set your idle duration. So let's fix that. Use blink. Okay, once the blink is finished, it should reset your idle duration. So it's not like you've been waiting throughout that blink, because the blink is already pretty powerful. It doesn't need any more OP. Is this E? What is this entity? F. F dot move dot idle duration equals 0. Swap the company. Oh yeah, package out of the autocomplete package, since I've heard that later. Company, huh? It's called Company. Is it only for Emacs? There we go. Okay, so now you blink and then the shield comes up. Love it. This is so cool. Emacs. I wonder if there's a Vim one. See, I'm already using UCompleteMe, and I know it has fuzzy search, but I'm not sure if it has fuzzy autocomplete. Wait, maybe it does. Does it? Hold on a second. Maybe it does. If I just start typing, wait. E.render.sprite. Okay, I would want to call like is flipped x, so is fx. Oh my god, it kind of works. It does, and if I press tab, I guess that works, shit. What if we did, what if it was just e, I wanted to type render, so rnd. That works too. Shit, I didn't know there was fuzzy matching in this. I can be even more lazy now. Yeah! I knew I switched to Vim for a reason. Like, what if I wanted to call set animation? Yeah, this is sweet. I didn't even know that. Wow. Thanks for mentioning that, Salad. That's, yeah, it's through UCompleteMe, which is, yeah, uses Y command is one of their things. But yeah, the YCM is the UCompleteMe, and then these are all its commands you can call. You sometimes have to call restart server. I have to do that a lot. It's got this weird bug now. Like, what's it giving me all this stuff for? I don't know. It's just started doing that today. Later, Exotic Burns. What's up, Clone Geek? Okay, so we got an enable shield animation. He was using a plugin for fuzzy. Yeah. I know, I should hack my Xcode. Okay, so we get the frame, we get the current Z that it should be. You said visible on the mirrored sprite. Set it sprite frame, set flipped X. Enable shield. Create the three shield sprites. Okay. A couple more little tweaks. You're working on some to-do list items? Cool, man. Yeah, everything's great here. Just working on my game. Wow. Oh, I didn't know Sublime could do that with the Clang back end. Yeah. I don't know. I would try like Cygwin or something so you get an actual Unix terminal to work with rather than trying to get it to work on the their, you know. Okay, it's just a couple of little optimizations. Like, we know the content size is always the same. Going back in his house. It's funny, Rocket, when he types on the keyboard. I like to hear what the hamster has to say. It's cool. probably needs a good animation or a sound effect too when it comes up. Let's do a little sound effect. Hopefully this doesn't kill the audio for the stream. You never know. It's like rolling the dice when you open different apps. La 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 la. Hey. What the hell happened to the chat window? I swear it was better than that when I started. What? I thought I made a custom. Oh, I didn't. That's not it. Oh, it might be called Chi Shield or whatever. Yeah, there it is. Chi Shield. Those all sounded the same to me, but I'm sure they're subtly different. Did the audio seriously die? I thought it was okay. Hello? Hello? Looks okay. I think it's called, is it called She Shield? There it is. Okay, I'm gonna isolate this last bit of it. I think this is all rendered from this one massive instrument here. Yeah, it's this massive instrument here, which makes this shield sound. All right, let's go. Oh, this changed the tempo, interesting. But does that change the warp for this? Yeah, it's warped. Oh, they sounded all the same, but they're actually different tempos. It's crazy. Okay, let's move this back to, what is this, 150.85? Let's move it back, what's this one? 130? And zoom in and just isolate this last bit, make it fade in. My majestic voice, thanks, man. Oh, it was a hiccup? Oh, good. I'm glad. I'm tired of these glitches. I'm trying to make a game here, not work on glitchy software. It's like one of my pet peeves is bugs in other people's software. Bugs the hell out of me. Literally and figuratively. Especially mobile software. Oh, good, good. This is sounding pretty good. It's like, woo, bringing up the shield. I think it should end at about maybe 80%. Shouldn't be as loud as most sound effects, because you're going to hear this all the freaking time when you have the shield. Maybe a little more. Damn insects! Gotta squash them! Let's convert this one to mono. Wait, what? What? No, don't convert that to mono. It's a cool sound effect. It could benefit from stereo-ness. Okay, so we'll call this one chi shield up zero. And then rock's gonna need it. The chat will just. Yep, it's gonna eat up the whole screen. It's gonna be even less readable. It's gonna be awesome. I can't wait. Shield item. Okay, shield. Enable. Imagine Bob Ross but coding. It'd be so great. It's these happy little tree bulls. Oh, it's your nice, baby. Yeah. More water. Okay, we got the shield up sound. And go to that tag for enable shield. We don't want that. If enabled, e dot profile dot profile dot play sound shield up. Is that it? Shield enable. Is gonna be crazy hard to hear. This place. Yes. Got it done before it was finished compiling. What's on the menu? We're gonna have some pizza. And we're gonna have burritos, and we're gonna have cider beverages, and a jar of mayonnaise, and you know, that kind of stuff. Was chaos. What happened here? What happened here? Oh, you gotta see at least one of his episodes, Rocket. Also, your shield becomes up the second you're done at swinging of the attack. That's such an OP thing. Mayo, yes, on the burritos. Mayo everywhere. We're gonna put it in our drinks. Mayo and cider together, mixed together. Someone has to chug the mayo. Chug? You mean chug? You guys call it jug? You jug the mayo or chug the mayo? So using the I guess it would be attack component, where it, or attack system. Yeah, attack system. Man, now that I can see when the shield is up, I can see that there's these flaws in when the shield is up and all that. So take not attacking. Take first attack. Oh, so tick attacking. Tick attacking. E dot move dial duration equals 0. Chug. Oh, okay. I was just wondering. It's all right, man. It's your, what, second, third language? How many languages do you know, Rocket? You know German? Dutch, of course. Spanish, you know Spanish? Ah, it's still doing it. What do you call wear football? What do you call aware football? You mean where you play football? Do you mean football or soccer? It's called a field, though. You mean the football field? Yeah. Even drawing the sword. Yeah, you made some progress in your VR game. You getting sidetracked? Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, you call it a football pitch. Huh. Oh, it's not the whole attack. That's right. It's the... What is it? It's got an attack timer. Attack. There's a delay, a total duration, a timer. Shake duration, shake. I think it's the overall timer. Oh, sweet, Zilton, I see what you're saying. So you, instead of using a texture for your sky, you used a noise to create stars. That's cool, man. It's a really cool idea. There it is. Start attack. Start timer. I think which just means timer equals delay plus. Yeah. Okay, if you have any timer whatsoever. Wait. Is active and is elapsed. No, not the is now attacking. It's the is active. If attack opponent is active. Which really means that in the end, this should all be in the move system. If move system, if we're here, we're applying the move system tick to a certain id. Spelled color in Americanese. Yeah, organization. Yeah. Because you would break it. Yeah, cool. You got a flashlight? Nice, man. Okay, so I need to add to this line here. If you either, you can set add to the idle timer if this entity does not have an attack component, or if the attack component is not active. Let's try that. Why do they use both remotes? What's with that? If it's still working or not. With two Vive controllers? I don't know. I'll be right back. So the attack being active. Yeah, this looks right. The attack empty or the attack not active. All right, let's start by making it a little more obvious when the shield. I'll make the delay between how long you have to wait longer, so it seems it's easier to recognize. Where was that again? Attack system? No. Yeah. Tax system? There it is. Oh my God, the shield delay is only a tenth of a second. Really? Let's make it a whole second long. Maybe that just needs to be a little longer, actually. See you, Zilton. Later, man. Yeah, see, he gets he, it's like oh, there's an overall delay overall duration and delay, but duration applies to the attack, but the attack duration is slower than the actual render. Something to do with combo timer. Really, there's no other way to know this, like. Yeah. That's really the only thing to do here. Well, okay. I guess this is as good as it's going to be for now. So, I guess when you're attacking, well, white space. Does white space mess up assembly code? Yeah, I don't think it does. I don't know though, I'm not a really, haven't really done that much assembly code. At least make using what? Using the blink. Take another moment. That's better. Oh, nice. After the animation happens, then you get idle duration equals 0. Okay, so attack system tick. When it starts an attack, it'll schedule, before tick function. Remember this id? Schedule it for e.anim dot e dot get anim duration. Okay, so this is going to basically make it so for the duration of the player's attack animation, it's not going to be, the player's not going to be idle. Oh, but it's doing it twice there. So that doesn't work either. Very well, at least. What it really should do is in the move system, just check for the melee animation. So if it, so it proceeds to add to the player's idle timer if the attack is empty, or if the attack is not empty and the player is not performing a melee animation. Yeah, these are melee animations. Okay. Try that. I'm just trying to make it so the shield does not become active while you're attacking. Which is super OP. There we go. Nice, it's so much better. Yeah, I like the way that works now. So it's also happening really fast after you unsheath the sword. Oh, wait a minute, it already has that. When you unsheath the sword, it sets the input. Oh, but it deletes the input lock an 8/10 of a second later. Wait a minute, what if I set a negative idle timer? Oh, that might work. Oh, whoops, idle duration. Greater than 10, less than 10.2, idle duration equals 0. Greater than shield delay. So yeah, it either just adds to the delta. Oh, this is cool. So I can comment this out and just set a negative idle duration when we're starting an attack. What's up, Dan Grit? Okay, cool. So that's all set up. All right, so now we can use a negative idle duration in start attack. So the idle durations become negative e.anim or e get anim duration. Okay, let's see if that works. Yeah, it worked. Awesome. That's awesome. That's a great way to do that. So, okay, I could use that for a lot of different situations, like when you draw the sword. Need this buffer anymore. Don't need that. Wait a minute, idle zero right there. There's an issue with that. So if idle duration was zero. Dan Grant, how long does the pixel art usually take? A long time. I'm redoing all the pixel art for the player right now, and it's taken me about 2 weeks so far just to like update it all. It's a lot of work because this is like, it used to be 210 files. Now it's like, this is just for the player, the main hero. But now it's getting more like 150, so it's better. But yeah, there's a shitload of pixel art for the main player. There's so many frames. There's like 1500 different frames. Okay, move idle duration. If the idle duration is zero and the node.idle is zero. Do I ever do that? Yeah, there's one place where I put idle 0.0. That should be meaningless. Idle 0.0? Is this really the only place I use this? Is there any way? What about that? No, okay. Yeah, it looks like it's just this one place. I'm guessing, I'm just gonna go ahead and change that to something really small. And then make it so node.idle has to be greater than zero for it to be considered. That's better. Dengrid, am I ready for Hyperlight Drifter knockoff comments? Gosh, that's such an insult. But, yes, I guess I'm ready. I don't know. You want to throw some at me or something? So do I need phase pause tick? No. Shit. Okay, so use sword when you unsheath. Here we go. Okay, so we'll set a negative idle duration here. Thank you, Dommy Killer. Thank you, Dommy Killer, so much. Gosh. It's like, what, is the last 2 years of my life just like been trying to knock off another game the entire time? I was sitting there constantly looking at Hyper Light Drifter going, oh, let me make my game something like that. That's better. Okay, so when you unsheath, it's still taking a second. Huh, what's wrong with that? So why didn't that work? It does the, this is the unsheath animation, right? Phasmid's unsheath, yeah, this is the unsheath animation. We've set the animation. We set a negative idle duration. I guess the only thing that could be changing that is if the idle duration gets reset to zero somewhere else in the code, which could be happening. Oh, I guess it could be in move system. Like checking to see if it's just doesn't reset e.move.idleDuration. Is greater than or equal to zero. Then we can set it to zero. Yeah, thanks, Salad. It is. In fact, I had never even heard of Hyperlight Drifter when I first started this game. But they both of these games, Hyperlight Drifter and Songbringer, have very similar influences. They're very influenced by Zelda. This game's pretty influenced by Zelda, too. So if anything, Songbringer is a Zelda ripoff. But it's not. It's not a ripoff. This is a completely unique creation. It's just it has similar mechanics. It's weird. Okay, so negative, and then maybe I'll just add a little bit more. Yeah, that's definitely going to happen. Yeah. People will get it, I'm sure. Most people will get it, and then there'll be like 2% of people, which will be total trolls. Very hurtful trolls. Still lights up real fast. Like, it's definitely resetting the idle duration then. Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely resetting the idle duration somewhere. This isn't going to work. We need to use Xcode for that. So it resets your idle timer if you press a button. I guess we could set this to if this is greater than zero. It is. Thank you, Ishni. Sorry, I just had some flashbacks there to the Kickstarter and going through Greenlight. It's kind of, I did the math on the numbers, but 98% of people like said positive comments, but there was like that 2% of people that say so extremely hateful and hurtful comments that it like almost makes you want to just like pull a Phil Fish. Oh man, sorry Phil. This is full time, Dengrit. That's a pretty good point, Salad, right? Even if it was a blatant copy, people would still probably buy it. That's fine to reset the title, the duration there. And this sets that. There's only one other one, story. So there's nowhere else that could be resetting. Oh, except for maybe here. This is where you're catching the top hat. So actually we'll set F to negative F dot get an M duration. True, Salad, yeah. Oh, there it goes. Sweet, one of those must have been it then. So now I don't need this whole 1.5 second extra bit. There it goes. Okay, cool. That fixed it. Another thing is that when you throw the top hat, Yes, Zombie Killer, thank you. You totally get it. I definitely agree. The word knockoff is really insulting, but also it's definitely, I think, misused in a lot of these cases. And I like the way you're putting it. It's a style of game. It's a genre. You're going to say every game in a certain genre is all knockoffs? Yes, thank you, Dummy Killer. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. That old-fashioned thing called fun? Weissman. Okay, it needs a fade out animation too. Oh, wait, does Fade do that automatically? No, it doesn't. Okay, let's see. Before I commit to doing this, I'm gonna do it the fast way first. So fade to create over like a half second fade out and then hide. See if that looks good. Yes, mod man. It's not fading fast enough. I think it needs to set its global Z no matter what. Oh, and its sprite frame and flip text. All these. Oh, wait, did I change the time? See you each and any later, man. What's up, Veden? Coco's Cross? Oh, you mean Coco's 2DX? I like it. I like it a lot, but it's kind of bloated. That's my only complaint about it. Good design is half the battle. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Implementation's really important. So I think what's happening here is that zero is really bright. I don't know why. Needs to stop all its actions it's currently running as well. Wait, oh, let's use the fuzzy match. Stop all actions. Hey, it worked. Fuzzy matching, so cool. Yeah. Exactly, it's mod man. Oh, okay. Let's see what's happening. It's fading out really slow, so that, and then you walk up a little bit. So really, this should be more like negative, I don't know, negative one actually is probably okay. So let's try just fading it out with a tenth of a second. It might just be better to just set visible false here. Instead of trying to do an animation. It does look really good, except for the part where its global Z is off. I guess I could make that like 10. Good. Now it's got a nice little fade out. Oh, it looks weird though if you're standing in front of stuff, damn it. So I can't use like that negative 10, that's too much. Even like negative. Well, the height of the player was about 6. 6 is probably all we can go. Okay, I think that's enough work on this for today. So it's pretty cool. So I started today's stream without this whole shield animation thing here. You didn't know when your shield was up. The shield is this item that you have which protects you from damage. If you're still. So the thing was, if you're still, you didn't really know that it was up and the shield was active. So this just makes it so you can see visually like, oh, there, the shield's up. So I'm not so sure about the at first I loved how it was all bright at first, but now it's starting to kind of bug me after seeing it like a billion times, like brightness. I don't know what to do with that, so I'll think about it. So dinner time for Wizard Foo here. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody, and I appreciate you all. Appreciate all your support. Thank you for all the great you know, ideas and backing the project and everything you guys have done. So I appreciate it. See you all next time. Later.